To say that the Pro Bowl is boring or bad is to dig up and beat a dead horse that's already been in the ground for a decade. But things are only getting worse for the game that's meant to showcase the NFL's biggest and brightest names. Among all the All-Star games hosted each year by the major sports leagues in the US, the Pro Bowl consistently sets the standard for how to make the biggest mockery of the sport it's meant to honor. Just take a look at this past year. Even the weather conspired against the NFL to create one of the ugliest and most boring games yet seen in the history of sport. I think more than anything, this clip of Jason Witten breaking the trophy is the perfect allegory for everything the game has become in recent years, a cheap decoration that only gets attention for how laughable the whole thing is. While TV ratings did increase a bit last year in comparison with 2016 and 2017, it was still the third lowest in 12 seasons, and when compared with all NFL games in 2018, it comes in as the seventh lowest out of 121 eligible broadcasts. But was it always this insignificant? Well, I'm not gonna act all high and mighty like the Pro Bowl was ever a respected competition, or that it ever really should have been, but it seems like the disdain for this whole event has skyrocketed in the past few seasons. Kinda like how you don't think you can hate Roger Goodell more than you do now, and then he just does anything at all, and your blood finds a way to boil even hotter. Historically, the game was never taken seriously, well, with this one exception. But at the very minimum, the players and fans did enjoy being there and taking part in it. So today, we're going to talk about how the NFL has drained all of the enjoyment from the Pro Bowl and how it can restore at least some of that surface-level appeal. But before we jump into it, I'd like to thank Squarespace for sponsoring today's video. For those of you who haven't heard of them before, Squarespace is the all-in-one platform to help build a sleek, professional website with only a few mouse clicks needed. Now, I've got no previous background in building web pages, but they make it so easy to customize a site to your needs that I even had fun throwing together my own little website just for this video. They have templates that easily accommodate whatever style you're looking to build around, whether that's a blog, a band, an online store, you name it. They've also got every tool you need to bring your website to life. Features like video backgrounds, built-in mobile layouts for each template, tons of different fonts and customization, and even a logo designer to help showcase your brand or business. If you're ready to take your presence online to the next level, then head on over to Squarespace to start up a free trial and check out their service, and then whenever you're ready to launch, click the pinned link down below in order to get 10% off your first purchase on a website or domain. Again, that's squarespace.com/set the edge to turn your ideas into online realities. So in order to understand how sideways things have gone for the Pro Bowl over the past decade or so, let's take a look at why it's really a doomed concept in the first place. For starters, it's hardly viewed as an honor or reward nowadays, aside from the title that it places on a player's resume. Since 1980, the Pro Bowl was essentially a free vacation to Hawaii as a nice little incentive for the league stars who make NFL games so fun to watch through the whole season. So even if you didn't care about the game, which no one really does, you're still in Hawaii with your family for a week after a 16-game season and possibly multiple weeks of playoffs. But over the past 3 years, instead of the tropical paradise of Hawaii, it's been played in Orlando, Florida. Now you can take it from me, I am from Florida. This place is not a reward, especially Orlando. The entire state is crazy, it's insanely humid, and it's balanced out with an equal amount of elderly people and alligators. So it's not surprising that in recent years, a lot of players just don't want to attend at all, because Pro Bowl week in Hawaii was special. But Orlando's tourist trap incarnate just absolutely pales in comparison. So if you're going to try and fix the plague of players dropping out like they have in recent years, and just maybe try to improve the attitude surrounding the whole event, move the game back to Aloha Stadium in Hawaii. Since we're on the topic of getting the very best players to participate, I'm going to hit you with a bit of a controversial opinion regarding the players that are selected each year to the Pro Bowl. The fan vote needs to be abolished. I know I'll probably get some disagreement for this one, which is perfectly fine, but in my opinion, the popularity contest nature of the Pro Bowl is ruining a lot of the legitimacy surrounding it as an individual achievement. When you're measuring players on their individual greatness at the end of a career, the amount of Pro Bowls a player has lies just below All-Pro selections and major awards like Offensive and Defensive Player of the Year. But under the current system, fan voting makes up 1/3 of the selection process for Pro Bowlers, and just based on fan base size alone, that has the ability to derail a lot of the legitimacy surrounding that title. For those of you who watched my Matt Ryan video, you know that he was snubbed for Mitch Trubisky. He was also left off the roster for Dak Prescott last season. In fact, 3 of the 5 first-team All-Pro offensive linemen were not on the Pro Bowl roster, not to mention poor Colts linebacker Darius Leonard, who led the league in tackles and was named Defensive Rookie of the Year and first-team All-Pro, again as a rookie, who did not make the Pro Bowl. That makes me just want to throw the whole thing in the garbage can and light it on fire. The Pro Bowl shouldn't just be for big names and big market teams year after year, it should reflect the best in the league, and there's no better way to consistently do that than to determine selections through the league's coaches and players the way that it used to be done back when it really meant something. Considering the contract incentives and legacy implications of each Pro Bowl nod, there's no doubt that it would add a better sense of honor and importance to being selected if the system was built towards the best players making it there. Piggybacking on that very last sentence, the whole event needs to be moved back to the week after the Super Bowl, because that's where it belongs. I understand the perspective of the NFL trying to have some kind of football between the conference championships and the Super Bowl, but when you sandwich it between the two biggest weeks of the entire pro football season, it ends up becoming something you ignore in favor of all coverage leading up to that year's Super Bowl. But if you push the Pro Bowl to after the Super Bowl where it used to be, it allows the two best teams in the league to have their players involved as well, and there are probably a good amount of them on those rosters considering they were just in the Super Bowl. By simply placing the game in Hawaii where it belongs, eliminating fan voting, and allowing the teams who made the Super Bowl to play in it, the Pro Bowl could instantly see a jump in quality. But there is still one massive problem, and that's the game itself. This is a pretty easy one to tackle, because unlike real football, there's very little tackling actually involved. While a lot of fans would love to see a competitive football game between the very best of each NFL conference, the problem is that football is easily the most dangerous and risk-filled pro sport there is. There is no realistic way that an NFL team would ever want its top talent to go out there and risk their upcoming season in an exhibition match. I don't care if you offer a ton more money to the players, I don't care if you offer them the chance to be on the cover of the next 14 Maddens, no organization is going to let their players attend at all if you try to make this game competitive. So you can tell me in the comments about how soft the league is if you want, but that's not going to change anything. So with that established, you're always going to be guaranteed a drastically inferior product to what you see on Sundays, so long as the Pro Bowl remains the same boring, contrived, effortless waste of 3 hours. So how can you fix this? Well, you can get rid of it. Yes, it is a long-standing tradition, but at this rate, there isn't much other than nostalgia that's in the way of dropping it completely. The players hate it, the fans hate it, no one would notice if it wasn't played at all, so why do we keep being reminded of it year after year? It's not like there's no way to replace it, with a couple of alternatives already in existence, like expanding upon the skills challenges that have actually received some positive feedback. When there are more people talking about a game of dodgeball than they are about what's supposed to be the weekend's main event, it's pretty clear that everyone's time is just being wasted at that point. So instead of a soulless exhibition game, you could have multiple main events, like a 7-on-7 flag tournament of skill players that would allow fans to root for their favorite group and encourage some friendly rivalry between the different players. At the very least, that would allow them to compete for bragging rights rather than just meaninglessly representing their conferences, and simultaneously, it would reduce injury risk to allow for more competitiveness. For the big men, reintroduce strength competitions, and maybe add in an eating contest or two so that I can watch Akeem Hicks stuff down hamburgers like he stuffs running backs at the line of scrimmage. The NFL has already got the right idea in emphasizing these skill competitions, but the complex relay races and obstacle courses they've been putting together will always be less interesting to me than just watching my favorite players run a foot race against each other and be able to talk smack to their friends on live TV. I'd be way more interested in watching like a dance-off or a video game tournament. The entire week is supposed to be about the players getting to be themselves outside of the confines of their weekly press conferences and interviews, so just about anything that shows that side of fan-favorite NFL players would be a big step towards making the Pro Bowl less of a joke and more of an entertaining event to close out the season. I mean, at this point, Roger Goodell has already threatened to get rid of the week entirely, and while the Pro Bowl isn't something I've been interested in watching for years now, I'd still hate to see it leave when there are ways for it to be salvaged. While I still appreciate the game's tradition that has lasted for decades and decades now, I think it might be just about time for the Pro Bowl to die, because that might be the only way left to keep it alive.